My dear students, today we are going to see about the biopiracy of neem, biopiracy of turmeric, biopiracy of basmati. What is biopiracy? Last class itself we have consulted about biopiracy. Biopiracy is an unauthorized use of plants and animals. It is the exploitation and utilization of bioresources from a country by several organizations and multinational companies without proper authorization. Biopiracy means it is the exploitation of the plants and animal species of one country by the multinational company of other countries without any proper intimation, proper authorization, proper legal activities. Biopiracy can be defined as the manipulation of intellectual property right laws by corporations to gain exclusive control over national genetic resources without giving adequate recognition or remuneration to the original possessors of those resources. So that is the general information about biopiracy. Now we'll pass on to biopiracy of neem. We know well the neem tree is our own property. The neem tree, the product of the neem oil has many beneficial activities. They have those products are many control measures. Medicinally, they are very important. They have medicinal properties. People of India used neem and its oil to control fungal infection and bacterial skin infection. Often and often, our body is infected by many microorganisms like fungi and bacteria. And these fungi and bacteria cause skin diseases, skin infection. For those infections, this is the best remedial measure, the neem product. Oil obtained from the neem is the best control measure for fungal skin infection and bacterial skin infections. India have shared the medicinal knowledge, medicinal property of the neem with the entire world. Pirating this knowledge, the United States Department of Agriculture, USDA, United States Department of Agriculture, and an American MNC multinational company, W.R. Grace, sought a patent from the European Patent Office, EPO, on the method for controlling diseases in plants by the aid of extracted hydrophobic neem oil. Hydrophobic neem oil means this will repel water. If this will not attract water, so that is hydrophobic neem oil. Patenting on the fungal and antibacterial properties of neem was an example for biopiracy, but the traditional knowledge of the Indians was protected. So that is the biopiracy of neem. Next, we pass on to the turmeric. Biopiracy of turmeric. The United States Patent and Trademark Office 1995 granted patent for turmeric as an antiseptic agent. Turmeric has been used by the Indians as a home remedy right from the beginning onwards, right from the birth. For a long time onwards, we are using turmeric as our home remedy for the quick healing of the wounds and also healing rashes from a long time onwards. It's a very good healing property for any kinds of wounds taking place in our body. And also any rashes appear on the skin of our body, the turmeric powder is considered as a very good medicinal property, medicinal substances which will cure the wounds of our body and rashes of our skin. This type of remedy was mentioned in the journal article published by the Indian Medical Association in the year 1953. Therefore, in this way, it was proved that the use of turmeric as an antiseptic, and it is not new to the world, and it is not a new invention, but it is formed a part of traditional knowledge of Indians. The objection in this case, U.S. Patent and Trademark Office was upheld, and traditional knowledge of the Indians was protected. So it is another example of biopiracy. Next, we will pass on to biopiracy of basmati. On September 2, 1997, the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office granted patent on basmati rice lines and grinds to the Texas-based company Rice Tech. This broad patent gives the company several rights, including exclusive use of the term basmati, as well property rights on the seeds and grinds from any crosses. The patent also covers the process of breeding rice lines, and the method to determine the cooking properties and the starch content of the rice grains. So as a whole, the patent covers as far as basmati rice grain is concerned, the starch which is present in the grain, the cooking properties of the basmati rice, all that is patented. India had periled the United States to take the matter to the WTO. WTO is the World Trade Organization, as infringement of the TRIPS agreement. What is the TRIPS agreement? The agreement on trade related aspects of intellectual property rights, that is an international legal agreement between all the members nations of the world, made organization, that is WTO, which could have resulted in major embracement for the USA. Hence, voluntarily, few decisions taken by the U.S. Patent Office. So, Rice Tech Company had to lose most of the claims and most importantly, the right to call the rice basmati. In the year 2002, the final decision was taken, so rice stake dropped down 15 climbs, resulting in clearing the path of Indian basmati rice exposed to the foreign countries. So the patent office ordered the patent name to be changed to Rice Lines 867. So that is as far as biopiracy of basmati rice is concerned. So far we have seen about the biopiracy, biopiracy of neem, biopiracy of turmeric, and biopiracy of basmati.